Mob it up. I gotta meld his leaf bash. Watch. I just gotta save it. Oh my god. I worked him. Oh, I meld his leaf bash! Stop the Jeremy opens here. I'm done. Please get this guy off me first. Okay, good. Go now. Finding? Keep this ticket? Keep him?
I got fear off.
I like Kolo.
I make yourself. I keep the ball, Give me a second. Can you help us? Fire?
Yep.
Good here for Cloud9. This is the game-winning setup. Garrote silence on Majidin. Can they take him down? He has the Gladiator safeguard. Now an attempt here from Resurgent. They're going after Snuts. But Snuts, I think he was able to weather the storm. He has his trinket. Better way. Blinding light play by Zach going in for that very extended crowd control chain. But they need follow-up. They sap off the blinding light. This could be good night for Cloud9. Resurgent look to take them down. They get a bit more crowd control, but it's not enough. Iron Bark is active. Snuts is likely to survive. Snuts. Kidney shot secured with a hammer of justice on Cubsy, but there's no follow-up. There's the blind. Cubsy trinkets out into a sap! Kolo saps Cubsy's trinket. He does manage to sneak in the Iron Bark, but that was a good play.
So getting out of more stuns, more crowd control, definitely going to be an advantage to Resurgent to deal a lot of damage. Great chain initiated here. Snuts is isolated. They pull all of his defensive lineup and still possibly kill him. Cubsy's in a sap. Snuts' Glider's Medallion gets spell stolen off. Are they going to move to match point? Cubsy's locked down in Dragon's Breath. Kolo looks to finish him off, and he's going to do it. Resurgent taking it down in a quick game three and move to match point.
What are we watching right now? Resurgent with the R and Paladin. They're looking unstoppable.
Be here in game number two. Not really of too much consequence just yet, aside from potentially Valido stealing some crowd control. Cedus sitting through a Cyclone, Sam being pressured down, huge attack by Resurgent. He isn't able to get away. Big pressure. Second ice block. Method Orange can't afford to be knocked out of the tournament. This is their counter map, their counter pick. They're down.
Kolo did a really good job there, actually shadow melded the bash. And got the counter crowd control on Cedu, and that's why they were able to get that second ice block. This is not looking good right now for Method Orange. Look at Samiam. He has no ice blocks whatsoever for another 4 minutes. Valido, Zach, they're all over him. They haven't been counter-pressured away. Zach, I mean, he's got no touch of karma right now. Sam lands a nice counter spell. Can they make anything happen with it? Really is the question. I can't help but feel like Method Orange is in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, Method Orange are in a lot of trouble right here. Cedu is interrupted. Ironbark needs to be enough, but he's cycloned. Ice Barrier gets crushed through. Trill with the clutch triple, trying to hold them at bay for a few more seconds, but Cedu doesn't really have those seconds. If Zach can connect, Sam will fall. Another Ice Barrier comes in the nick of time, but Kolo is getting cyclone after cyclone. Kolo with the carry. Resurgent take game two. That, they looked insane compared to the boys in this matchup. That was actually insane. Resurgent are dominating.
Yeah, well, ladies and gentlemen, this could be the final game of the day here. Grand final North America Summer Cup season number one. Zach, Kolo, Majordin are putting it to Method Orange. They could well end up winning this one. I've got a feeling these guys are going to pick up quite a few new fans in this tournament.
I mean, they definitely will. They were lucky they found confidence that I feel like they were lacking earlier on in the tournaments, but now with Majordin on this Major Oak Paladin, they're taking out Method Orange, they took out Cloud9, they took out the Mew Mew Kitty Cats. I mean, what else is going to be able to stop them? They're looking very far away from the fight. Kolo looks like he's sneaking over as if he wants to attack Cedu, but Trill intercepts, lands a double leg sweep, and a ton of damage onto Majordin. Temporal Shield about to go off just in the nick of time, and Kolo does want to go after Cedu. He anticipated this, but they're on match point, and that's a lot of damage coming through for Never Lucky. Potentially the tournament, lives on the line. Cedu is just going to go down. Never Lucky have done it. They took out the Spring Champions. They took out Cloud9, and now they've taken out the reigning BlizzCon Champions.
Come down to this next game. Cedu, how did they bring it back?
This synergy keeps their composure. They were able to execute that perfectly. I cannot believe that.
Escape. Novus is completely tapped on mana. Both teams are completely tapped. Novus takes a nice vortex. He gets Chun-Li back in line of sight. And Chun-Li is going to go down.
And Kolo
going to the final.
Oh, Kolo. What a great Ursa vortex right there. Unfortunately, Chun-Li's port has...
Named Pandas Fall. If they go down here, Method Synergy are looking in a good position as they gun down for Rumka. Immediately looking for that asphyxiate. Wallabear moves over for maybe a fear. No, they're going to race healers as they go after Kolo. Med deflects with an anti-magic zone. Kolo's going to try and tank that out. Astral Shift is up. Rumka has to link already. Kolo is getting raced down as well. Wind Shaman will fall first. Heck to get the adaptation, but Rumka into the range of death is barely hanging up on the silence and will. Oh, Method Synergy crushing out Panda Global in a dominating finish, 4-0.
And there is no denying that Method Synergy is the best team in North America. You are looking at your champions right now. They will be getting $50,000, and they are going to be a force.
Imprisonment on Kolo denies a lot of his damage. Cedu in bear form with the preemptive Iron Bar. Can he survive? He has a few more seconds. Darkness gets
Ring of Peace.
Out. Ring of Peace. Cedu's still in a lot of trouble. Barksian is looking to get away. Another Ring of Peace denies. Cedu has to hold on just a little bit longer. Does he manage to escape and get away? Zach there to reconnect with the touch of death. Cedu's so scared at this point.
I mean, he could easily fall at any point. That touch of death is about to explode. It's going to do huge damage. Kolo's done it. Kolo has done it. Never Lucky going to be 3-0 the reigning BlizzCon champions, Method Orange.
Kolo is going to be able to pull Cedu apart, the man that took his spot.
Yeah, Yeah, the Orange are in a lot of trouble right here. Cedu is interrupted. Einbrock needs to be in the opposite way. Blind and light play by Zach going in for that very extended crowd control chain. But they need follow-up. He sap off the blinding light.
He's all in. Shots.
He shots appeared. Taylor doesn't stop cutting. There's no follow-up. There's a blind.
Cutting the set.
He's attacked by Resurgence. He isn't able to get away.
Kolo.